Today we're going to talk about dressing your diamond disc. We get a lot of people who call in or write in to us and say, can I dress my electroplated diamond disc? Well, it's a bit of a confusing answer. It's a yes and no kind of thing. Yes, you can dress these with a dressing stick. No, you really shouldn't do it very often. And let me explain the reason why. So with our electroplated diamond disc, we have a single layer of diamonds on these discs that are coated on here and held in place with nickel. So if you dress this disc, you are damaging the only layer of diamonds that you have on this disc. It's not something you want to do very often because you are going to reduce the lifespan of this disc. That being said, when your disc has worn down to the point that it's not really performing well for you any longer, dressing this disc can get a little bit more life out of the disc for you and keep it going a little bit longer. It's a good stopgap measure between using the rest of this disc for its entire life before ordering a new disc and keep you up and running. And let me explain what's happening here. So with our single layer of diamonds on here, we have a random dispersion of the diamonds on the surface of this disc. When you start grinding with it, you're grinding on probably 20 to 30% of the diamonds that are on the surface of this disc. That makes it really, really aggressive. You've got space between those diamonds that make it more aggressive. As you grind more and more and more of those diamonds wear down and break down, you're grinding on more and more of the diamonds on the surface of this disc. So you're moving to, you know, 40, 50, 60, 70, up to 90% of the diamonds that you're grinding with. So it almost becomes like a tabletop then. There are so many diamonds that are contacting your glass, it's almost a flat surface. So there's not enough space between the diamonds to be aggressive and scratch and grind the glass. When you dress this disc, and I'll show you how to do that in a moment, what you're doing is you are breaking off some of these diamonds. So you are knocking those diamond heights down again so that you end up with a more uneven surface on the surface of the disc. So you're back to where you before, you may be on 80 or 90% of the diamonds on the disc. When you break several of these off again, then you're back to grinding on maybe 40 to 50% of the diamonds on the surface of the disc. So it's going to be much more aggressive on the glass again. It's a good way to kind of get a little bit more life out of this disc, but it is destructive. You are breaking diamonds off of the surface of this disc when you dress it. We have found that you can dress these maybe three, possibly four times on a large disc, 2 to 3 times maybe on a smaller disc, and that's it, before it's completely dead and you're just going to have to get a new one. But let me show you how that works right now. So we have here a 60 grit diamond disc, and this is our 12-inch lap grinder. And we're going to put this on here. And this disc is not terribly old, but it is definitely getting towards a point in its life where it's not as efficient as it used to be. So let's take a quick look at this disc and see how it's grinding at its lifespan right now. It's going to be not quite as aggressive as it used to be, but let's take a look. So I've got a piece of glass here that's got some texture on it and a little bit of chunk taken out of it. So, you know, it's a fair amount of glass that needs to come off, but a 60 grit should do pretty well with this. So let's take a look and see how this is going to go. And you can see a few swipes, it's taking some of the texture off, but you know, it's not doing it very fast. A 60 grit should be fairly aggressive. So let's go ahead and stop this, and I'm gonna show you how to dress this. So to dress your electroplated diamond disc, you can go ahead and put it on your machine with the wheel head, with the machine off. You wanna get a fair amount of water on top of the disc. And then we're going to take our aluminum oxide dressing stick. This is the same stick that we'd use with a centered diamond saw blade to redress that, or any other centered tools to dress those core drill saw blades. Same thing is going to work here. What we're going to do with our dressing stick is we are going to move and grind by hand, center to edge, edge to center, back and forth on our disc. What that's going to do is you are going to randomly be breaking off diamonds as you go in and out. So it'll end up kind of looking like spokes on a bicycle wheel. So all by hand. And that kind of gives you an idea of what I did to the corner of that dressing stick. Applied a fair amount of pressure because they are diamonds. So you're looking to try and break those off. And you can see on our wheel, you've got kind of these in and out strokes on the wheel. So we're going to turn our wheel head back on. And we're going to flush our disc with a lot of water to get all that stuff off the surface of our disc. Now we've got our glass piece again that you've seen. Still have a little bit of texture showing there, a little chip. Let's see what this does now. Now you may be able to tell just from the sound and the amount of glass coming off that's quite a bit more aggressive on the glass already. Taking a fair amount of glass off of this piece very quickly. You can see the glass coming off on the disc as I'm grinding, whereas you really couldn't see that before. So that has really upped the aggressiveness of this 60 grit pad very, very quickly. Again, you can see, you know, as I'm grinding, the ground glass coming off. So it has made this, and I'm getting almost through this chip already. That was fairly deep. The disc is much more aggressive again. It's almost like brand new. Not quite, but it's significantly more aggressive than it was. Now again, it's a destructive process, so you will wear down the life of your disc when you do this, but it's a great thing to do when your disc has really gotten to the point where it's not working well for you, and it'll keep it going for a little bit longer. It'll probably last less than half the life that it did before, but then you can dress it again. And it'll go a little bit less time after that until you'll dress it and you won't see a whole lot of difference. And then that's the point that you really need a new disc. But this is a way that you can keep your disc going for a little bit longer and get as much life out of them as you possibly can. Hope this helps.